Here's an example with three festive baubles connected in series with segments of rope. Let's identify the forces on each ball explicitly using a free body diagram for each and see how the tensions transfer the forces. For bauble A, I've got an upward tension due to the rope from above. I've got a downward tension from the rope below. And I've got the force of gravity on that bauble A. Those are the only three forces acting on that object, on that bauble A. For B, similar, I've got an upward tension, T2. I've got a downward tension, T3. And again, I've got the force of gravity acting on that bauble. And I'll do that one more time. For the bottom, I've got an upward tension, T3, and no downward tension, there's no other rope connected, but I do have the force of gravity acting on it. And if I define this as the positive y direction, I have no forces acting in the x direction, so I really only need to define the y here that I'm interested in. And by doing so then, I know that this is now a negative MAG. This is equal to a negative MBG. And this is equal to a negative MCG because it's downward. Those will all be negative, as well as some of the tensions. When I get that to there, I'll show it. For the bottom one, you'll notice then, if I add up these forces, I've got T3 acting upwards, so I've got a positive T3, and I've got a negative MCG, and it's hanging in equilibrium, there's no acceleration, and so the net force is equal to zero. And that tells me then that T3 is equal to MCG. Likewise, I can work it out for bauble B. I've got a positive T2 upward. I've got a negative T3 because it's downward. And I've got its own weight all acting on that bauble. And it's in equilibrium, again set equal to zero. And so tension 2 is balancing out its own weight for that bauble. And T3, recall, I'm going to add it now to this side when I've brought it over. But remember that it's equal to, in fact, I'm going to substitute it in. It's equal to the weight of the green bauble. And so not surprising, tension 2 is supporting the weight of both of those baubles. And finally, we can see for T1, it's positive direction. I've got a negative T2. And I've got a negative MAG that I'm adding in there. Those all equal to zero. And solving then T1, take the other two to the other side, they become positive. That means I've got MAG plus T2. I can substitute from below, leaving me with that. So again, rather intuitively, the top tension is supporting all three weights. The middle tension is supporting just the weight of the lower two, and the bottom tension is supporting the weight of just the bottom bauble, the green bauble. And all of them have a net force equal to zero. They're not moving, they're hanging in equilibrium. So if I answer the questions up above, which rope has the greatest tension? The top one. It's supporting all three weights. What are the forces on each ball? The net force on each ball is equal to zero because it's hanging in equilibrium. And the free body diagram shows us the net forces and how those come about.